Hi, this is Jyotika and welcome to your third CSS tutorial. Today, we are going to talk about styling the text on your web page. There are lots of typography related CSS properties that can be used to change the style of text. And one of those is to basically style the font of your text. Some of the things related to styling the font are the font family, font style, font weight, font variant, font size. We could also change the color and background color of our text like we saw in the previous video. We could also alter the line height, add some decoration, or change the alignment of our text. Today, let's talk about font family. Font families are just different types of text. If you have used Word before, then you have most probably chosen one of these Arial, Verdana, Georgia to change the style of your text. All these are nothing but different types of fonts. And you can do the same thing with your web pages. So how it works is, again you use the syntax rule. You have the selector, the property, and then your value. In this case, I have taken H1 heading as my selector since I want to change the style of the H1 heading. Then inside the curly brackets, I have the CSS property of font family, which is used to change the font of this heading, followed by colon and the value or the name of the font I want. Here I have written the value as Arial. So now, whenever the browser sees an H1 heading, it will not use the browser default heading, but instead it will use the Arial font. I've got some more examples of fonts here like Verdana, Courier New, Georgia, Papyrus. Now there is one more thing to note about font family names. While it's not required, it's recommended to add quotes to font family names that contain spaces. Like I added here for Courier New. These can be single or double quotes. Also, if the font names contain numbers or characters other than a hyphen, these characters must be escaped by adding a backslash before the invalid character. Again, another option is to wrap the font family name in single or double quotes, which personally I find a lot easier to manage. Now, every single browser doesn't support everything. We see this even with HTML. Some browsers support some elements, some don't. In the same way, some browsers support some fonts and others don't. Also, sometimes the user doesn't have a particular font installed on their computer. So what you must do is provide alternatives. In this example, I have given the browser three different alternatives to use. The first value must be your first choice, and the following two options are alternative fonts declared in the order of preference. You can have number of optional values here. So what I'm telling the browser is, whenever you come to an H1 tag, I want you to use the Helvetica font. But if you don't have the Helvetica font, go ahead and use the Calibri font. If you don't have that one, go ahead and use Arial. Now you might think, what if the browser doesn't have any three of these fonts? Well, if you remember when we first talked about cascading style sheets in the introductory lesson, we said if you write a rule and the browser can't support it, it will always go back to the browser default. So you don't need to worry about font or text disappearing from your web page because you gave it a bad font family. It will always show the browser default if something goes wrong. Now you might be wondering what this last word sans serif after the font values is. Well, it's the name of a generic font family. That means if the browser is unable to load any of these optional fonts mentioned by us, it will pick a similar font from the generic family mentioned by us. In CSS, there are five generic font families: serif, sans serif, monospace, cursive, and fantasy. Serif fonts have a small stroke at the edges of each letter. They create a sense of formality and elegance. Sans serif fonts have clean lines, no small strokes attached. They create a modern and minimalistic look. Serif and sans serif are typefaces that you will probably use the most often. Monospace fonts have all the letters of the same fixed width, whether it's a narrow I or a wider O. They are often used for displaying code and they create a mechanical look. Cursive fonts imitate human handwriting and are often used for wedding invitations or greeting cards. For the web, they are usually reserved for headlines or small decorative text details. Fantasy fonts are decorative or playful fonts. They too are usually reserved for headings and decorative details. But design trends often change. Earlier, sans serif was very popular and serif fonts were used sparingly. But over the years, there's been a rise in the use of serif fonts for the main content. For example, Medium uses a serif typeface for the majority of the text on their platform. Though trends may change, you should make sure you are using legible fonts. Now, all the different font names like Courier New, Helvetica, Arial, Times New Roman, etc. belong to one of these generic font families. So, to get the desired look on your web page and to maintain the design and layout of your page, always try to choose fonts that look similar and always include a generic font last. This generic font family name should match the declared font names. For example, Helvetica, Calibri, Arial all belong to sans serif family. So include sans serif in the end. And Courier New, Monaco, Lucida Console belong to monospace family. Also, the generic font names must always be declared without any quotes. But how do we know what fonts are available? There are a number of fonts like Arial and Times New Roman that are generally pre-installed on a majority of devices. These are often referred to as web-safe fonts. On csfontstack.com, you will find a list of all the web-safe fonts and they are also categorized by their generic font family name. You can safely use these fonts along with a few fallback fonts from this list. The support of different operating systems for the fonts is also mentioned. But as you can see, not all operating systems have the same fonts installed. Or sometimes it's possible that the user may have deleted some of them from the system. Luckily, CSS has a couple of ways for us to expand our font options with FontFace or online web services like Google Fonts, which we will be discussing in the upcoming tutorials. So, if you liked this video and are interested in more web development content, then don't forget to like and subscribe to CodeRange. And let me know in the comments if you have any questions. This is Jyotika signing off. Until next time, keep learning and keep coding.